But you knock that, you open up the door, and they're gonna keep coming, and you just boom, boom, boom.
Basically, all you gotta do is defend them until you get to your car. Then you can. The entire way.
Yo, what's up, guys? Welcome to the Nostalgia Podcast for episode 2. I'm Klep.
James.
Jake.
And thank you for the support on the first episode. Let's get right into the competition segment.
Yeah. Yes, sir. Okay, what are we doing first? We're doing competition, and we're going to do the beats games.
Yeah, what did I say?
What'd you say?
What did you say?
I said we're going to do the beat game.
What? Can't hear you.
Okay, so how this works is we're going to be blaring music in this, right?
Yes, and absolutely, then, and you got to try to guess our sentences.
Okay.
And we're each going to give you one sentence, and you have 3 tries to guess.
Okay, do that.
And we're going to take turns.
So we're going to start. You want me to start it?
Yeah, you go ahead.
Okay. All right. I'm ready.
You want to give them the first sentence? All
right. What song are you listening to?
Can you get besides your lips?
What song are you listening to?
Let's stop. Why is it so long? Do a shorter one.
What's the song?
What is the song?
Yeah, you got it.
You got it. Okay.
All right. I'm sleeping under the bed.
One more time.
I'm sleeping under the bed.
How much money did you make today?
I didn't make anything.
I'm sleeping under the bed. I'm sleeping under the bed.
How much till paper is under my bed? I overdrive.
Alright, this last one. Last one.
How could I got that, like him saying I have one more try so easy.
I'm sleeping under the bed.
How many people are sleeping under the bed?
No. Hey, that was close.
Close. Not bad.
It was I'm sleeping under the bed.
Dang it. That was close. So close.
Can I go next?
I got one half.
Yeah, you can go next. Jake, I'll let you get in the first sentence.
Let me start the song over.
What is your favorite song?
I have no idea.
You know what it is? Okay. What is your favorite song?
What's my favorite song?
Good job, buddy. What is it?
What's your favorite song?
Yeah.
Pursuit of Happiness.
What'd you say?
Why is he yelling?
What are you selling? Chocolate.
All right. Could you talk any louder?
Why are you getting?
Am I walking my dog?
Yes. Alright. Could you talk any louder?
Can I talk any louder?
Yeah, you got it.
I get it?
Why'd you get an easy one?
Well, yours was easy too. You got it the first try. What you talking about?
True.
Alright.
You go first this time.
Alright. Do you
like... It besides your lips more.
I said that. I told you, he like keeps it flat.
I can't hear you.
Come on.
Go.
Do you like this mug?
Huh?
Do you like this mug?
Do I like what?
This mug.
This part?
Yeah, one more try.
Do I like this song?
No.
Do I like this one?
One more try.
Okay.
Do you like this mug?
No, I like this podcast.
Nope.
Okay, I got you. Okay, hey.
Okay.
Rain comes from clouds.
One more.
Rain comes from clouds.
What?
Come on.
Wait, say it one more time.
Rain comes from clouds.
Rain comes from the clouds.
Yes!
Woo! Let's go!
I definitely won that. You want to know what I said?
What?
Do you like this mug? I even pointed at it.
I was looking at your lips.
Yeah.
Hey, I was close. Do you like whatever?
That's good.
Now I think Jake has some questions for us in the trivia game.
Oh, I forgot about that. Yeah. I got my notes on his phone, so I gotta do it that way.
Thank you. Alright, so how are we doing this?
Why don't you replenish your aminos? That's what it says. Aminos.
Wait, so we're hitting the table?
I'm giving the rules. So look, I'm gonna ask a question. You can stop me mid-question and go, Okay,
we don't have to
keep your hands on your lap. Hands up in your lap.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Come on,
no, there you go. Yeah, it's gotta be obvious.
Okay.
And don't argue with me because I'm the ref here. Appreciate that.
I don't need them anymore.
Okay. So first question. What's your favorite color? That was
close. Blue.
Oh, dang it! Nice. I was gonna say that.
Nice.
Let's go.
No.
Hey, that's my favorite color.
My favorite color.
Hey!
Same colors.
Clark, one. James, zero.
Gosh dang it.
Okay. There's a little harder one. When's my birthday?
Oh,
he don't know.
Yes, I do.
Pirates!
June 3rd. That was two.
Really close.
July 3rd?
Hey! That's I got a guess close. Now.
Oh, my bad. Oh, my bad.
I'll give you a hint, because you missed. It's a third.
It's a third? July 3rd.
Dang.
Yeah.
May 3rd.
Okay. So neither of us got that?
Nope, you'll suck. Okay.
Still 1-0.
You ready?
Mm-hmm.
What's my favorite Call of Duty?
Modern Warfare 2.
What?
Black Ops 4.
Nope. Man, y'all suck. Are you doing a redemption on that one, or should we keep going?
Yeah, I think we should. You want to rock, paper, scissors for who gets to guess again?
Okay.
Black Ops 2.
There you go.
Yes.
1-1. We always do good high fives. Okay.
1-1.
1-1.
Question number four.
This is number four.
How old am I?
You weren't even ready. I wasn't even ready for that.
He's staring.
19.
Good job. Okay. Yep.
So
that 2-1. Match point him. You got one. This one's a little tough too. I feel like Klep's gonna know it. It's tough. When's on milk? What is
it? You stop.
Chapman.
I said you could say it midway, but I said Chapman. It wrong. I said wins my middle name. You got it right.
Chapman.
Klep won the trivia.
I didn't even know your middle name. You never told your middle name.
What's your middle name?
Ray.
I knew that.
Yeah.
James Ray. Cheers.
To win. You know? Punishment?
No.
Did we do punishment?
We never thought of it. So. Not for this one. Maybe next one.
Alright. Some ideas for punishments in the future.
Yeah, I was gonna say that too. Because we can't think of nothing.
Yeah. Alright, six.
Hey, if we reach 500 subs, though, what punishments? Jump in that lake out there.
Get us to 500 subs. Jake's gonna jump in the lake during winter.
Like the video and please press subscribe and leave a comment, please.
Alright. What are we on to next, boys?
Hypothetical questions.
These are our favorite.
Bear situation.
The bear situation. Okay. Situation I thought of in the shower, because that's when you have your best thoughts.
Yeah.
So, imagine, 15 miles in the woods, you're in Colorado, wild grizzly bears there. Wait, which one's bigger, grizzly or black?
Grizzlies.
Grizzly bear. 15 miles in the wood, grizzly bear, you're camping alone, you have a tent, you have a little fire out, and you're making yourself a little peanut butter jelly sandwich. So you head there, and somehow your keys fell on your peanut butter jelly sandwich whenever you weren't looking, but you put the jelly on the bread, and you went back in to go get the peanut butter from your tent. You came back out, and there's a mama bear walking up, sees your bread.
Can I stop you there?
What?
You put on jelly first instead of peanut butter?
Okay, so the grizzly bear's walking up.
Oh my God.
He goes to eat your sandwich with your keys, so he's gonna eat your keys. You look out the last second, what are you gonna do?
So your car is right there with
no,
you.
No, you have. Yes.
But
yes,
you don't have your keys because the grizzly bear ate your keys.
You don't know. It's there. I'm the grizzly bear. Food's here. Keys are in there. It's going like this, and you're looking at him.
But then he stops and looks at you, so he hasn't eaten it yet.
He doesn't see you. You can stop him, or you can let him eat it, go back in the tent. Just let him eat it, and you can walk your way back home.
15 miles is not that far.
Pretty far.
You know,
if you're walking, it's pretty far.
Yeah.
If you're running, it's...
Do I have my phone?
No service.
A satellite phone or anything?
I said no.
Wait, so you have your phone now?
Yes, but it's not gonna work. It's useless.
You can call 911 if you don't have service.
Not in the situation.
Okay.
So what are y'all doing?
So the bear's staring at me and I'm staring at the bear.
No, the bear didn't see you.
Oh, so he's still on his way. He's still on his way.
You know, it's risky to let him go because if you have to walk 15 miles,
you might see him again.
You might see him or.
You can tell me what I'm gonna do personally?
What?
So I'm gonna grab something I got. So like maybe like Maybe my, I wouldn't do my phone, but just if I got a stick or a rock nearby, I would open up the tent and throw the rock in the woods. So hopefully the bear would like look up and like run away because the bear like he heard something. Mm-hmm. So that's my hope.
What if he looks up right at you?
Then you're.
I'm dead. I'm
just like, you're just hoping he looks.
Yeah. I might get his baby and put it hostage with a rock.
That's wait, there's babies there?
Yeah, it's
but you're camping, so you're most likely gonna have a knife, right?
Yeah, sure. You have a knife. Oh, cool. I have a knife.
So I'm gonna sneak up on the bear
and then snip on him.
Get up on his back and give him a good slit.
Yeah,
right?
That's a grizzly. You do that. That's legendary.
Yeah.
That'd be pretty cool.
Yeah, I don't think your chances are very good, though.
Yeah, I don't think so either. But
or you could stab it in his eye.
You're just going to make him mad.
Yeah.
Well, that kind of distracts him for a
little
bit.
How big is a knife?
Why are we asking this?
I don't know.
Long enough.
Yeah, long enough.
3 inches. What?
Okay. If that's long enough. But
oh boy!
So we got a 3-inch pocket knife.
Came up on my nose.
You say that's about 3 inches, right?
I mean, my ruler is.
Okay. So I'm going up. I'm stabbing the bear in the eye, and he's gonna get mad. He's gonna turn, and as he's turning, like he's probably gonna turn the way that. You know, like, I stab him the right eye, he's going to turn to the right. I'm going to be on his left.
No, I think he's going to, like, flinch away. Like,
I think he's going to go, Roar! Away.
Yeah, that sounds like something a bear would do.
I was just trying to think.
He'd lean away from that. He'd be like,
Yeah. So he's going left if I stab him in the right.
Yeah. Wasn't matter.
Then I'm hitting him with that 1-2 Mayweather.
3-4 McGregor?
Yeah.
5-6 Jake Paul?
Yep. Exactly.
I think I'm just letting a bear walk. Eat my peanut butter and jelly.
With your keys.
Yeah, I don't care.
Really? You're not going
to? I'm going to try to get my keys
you're not
back.
You don't anything.
So even if bad. The bear, even if like, I look, think, I know I'm not going to be it's faster than the bear, but even if I think I'm faster than the bear, what I might do is run, like the bear kind
of. Does anyone know
I'm out there? The bear knows I'm coming, and I'm just sprinting for that peanut butter jelly sandwich. And I swipe down to grab it. As I grab it, stab her right in the eye. Sprint.
Drive by.
Exactly. So that, see, the bear's distracted.
Yeah.
You know?
But to your question, if you're going to tell people, yeah, like, would you tell someone you're going camping?
I would definitely tell someone if I'm going alone in the middle of the wilderness camp.
Yeah. Okay, then, yeah.
So then I probably wouldn't do anything. I'd just let them get me if they have to. Because they would know.
For about a couple days?
Yeah.
Okay.
But I might not have any food because you don't want peanut
butter
jelly.
Your parents are back home. You're in Colorado.
Okay. That's fine.
Okay.
I like my idea.
That's pretty cool. That'd be legendary if you pull it off. I
think my idea is that just throwing a rock or something.
Yeah. I mean, that's not bad. Like, little throw a rock and then, like, duck in the tent. Uh-huh. But then comes
the rest. So the bear's outside the tent?
Yeah.
Okay. So, what's the next question here?
I think I got a paradox for y'all.
Okay. Paradoxes.
This is the grandfather paradox. First, y'all know what a paradox is.
Yeah.
Jake does? Okay. Well, basically, if y'all don't know, it's like a thing that continuously happens. It's like going in a circle. What was your analogy that you used there?
So you got an extension cord, plug the cord in the extension cord, imagine there's like a little bit of electricity, so it keeps going around in circles.
Yeah, exactly.
So if that would work.
Yeah.
So you have you and your father, and your father's father, so your grandfather. And you build a time machine to go back in time. And then you, for some reason, don't worry about it.
Why would I kill my grandpa? Yeah.
I haven't even said that part yet.
Oh, sorry.
Just keep talking, dude.
And then
you've heard this one before.
for some reason, you decide that you're going to kill your grandfather. And then, so if you kill your grandfather, that means your father will not exist. And if your father does not exist, that means you cannot exist. And if you can't exist, you don't have the capabilities of creating a time machine to go back to kill your grandfather. Hmm. Which means your grandfather would now exist again. And then it's just a continuous loop.
That hurts my brain.
When are you killing your grandfather? Is he like a baby?
He's young enough that he hasn't had a father yet. I gotta clarify that.
It's tough.
So like, my papa and his teen years.
Mm-hmm.
His teens.
Yeah.
So, like, my brain hurts really bad. So, like, are you trying to think, like, is there a way that he could kill his grandpa and it would work? Because I think I have a way.
You have a solution?
So, what you got to do, you got to somehow get the reproduction stuff out of your grandpa. And then you save that refrigerator and you kill him.
Now, how are you pulling that off?
But I don't know about that part. You have to convince.
But how are you going to save it if you already, if you kill your grandfather and then you're dead, you couldn't have been up there to save it in the first place?
Well, that's why you can save.
You weren't there to save it. Your grandpa.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's a lot to think about.
Yeah, because
I think you're dead if you do that.
Yeah,
that's what I think.
But if you're dead, then you're alive.
Because you haven't killed your grandfather.
But if you're alive, you're dead. So, I mean, it's like, it makes no sense. So, what would happen?
A paradox.
You would split. It'd be like...
So, would that mean, like, if I killed my grandfather whenever I was back in time, I would just then just become my own person without any father or grandparents?
No, you'd be dead.
You'd stop existing. But if you stop existing, you can't kill your grandfather, and your grandfather exists again, then you're existing and go back in time.
You ever seen Infinite War? Where you start...
Yeah, so, but that's what I was thinking. It's kind of just
disappear.
Yeah,
like I don't feel
turned good.
Weird
shark.
Sad times. That's crazy. I hope we never hear Paradox ever again. I didn't like it.
The fan is on.
Let's pray to everything that y'all have not been hearing this entire time.
They have. Is the camera still good?
Actually, no. It's not as loud as normal.
Is the camera still good?
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
I forgot to turn it off again. We literally said we cannot forget to turn off the fan. It's like,
yeah.
That technical difficulty.
It's been going this whole time.
Yeah. Klep looked at me. He's like, the fan's on. I was like,
that's what we are saying. I always do these little.
Yeah.
Hey. Oh, you like energy? Klep's never had this before.
So, are we done with the paradox or what?
Unless you got any more. Oh my gosh.
I don't know.
Do I got any more to say about it?
I don't like it.
I don't want
to hear it ever again.
Right.
Next question then.
Alright, so if y'all were trapped in an elevator, would you be able to get out on your own?
Absolutely. I'm never dying. Like, I don't know if I've told you this before, but any situation you put me in, I'm going to live. So, what I'd probably do in this situation.
Because you're 5'2, right?
He can squeeze out easier.
Yeah.
No, it's because I'm tall enough to jump up and go.
On the what?
Okay, listen. All elevators, y'all probably don't know this, but you can pull out the tile, and there's always a trap door to get up on the top of the elevator.
Like in Star Wars? Eventually soon.
That's where I got my information, yeah. So, you jump up there, get it, and then I'll get my lightsaber out. No, I'm kidding. So, then, I'm imagining it's an enclosed one, not like one of those see-through ones.
Yeah, right. How most elevators are.
Yeah. So
you want to talk about how you are with elevators, Jake?
No.
Remember the one in...
Listen! Let me talk.
You remember that?
Okay, so look, a story... See, look, a story... If I say that, I can almost touch the roof, right? Yes, I can. Okay, so if I'm up on top of the elevator, I'm going to be able to reach the next story. So, and those can open pretty easily. So, whenever... Okay.
Yeah, I'd be able to make it.
So, sorry. I'm up on top of the elevator. I'm going to be able to open it up and pull myself up, jump up, get on top, and I'm out.
Aren't there like
what if the elevator starts going up as soon as you get on top? Like,
it's stuck. The elevator's stuck,
jump back in the trap door.
It becomes unstuck.
Then you just jump back in.
Yeah, that was a dumb question. If it goes down, that's when you're really screwed because you're going to go.
That's when you need to grab the ladder as fast as possible.
Yeah. Like, R2, stop.
Or you jump. Right before it's the bottom, yeah.
I don't think that would actually
work. I don't think it works. Well,
I have heard that the only way to survive an elevator falling down, you lay on the floor chest first, because then you'll go and you'll just hit your back up on the top of the elevator. They said it's the only way to survive.
Interesting.
Yep. Read it on CNN.
On to the next one.
Taking a little long to read.
Yeah. Go ahead. If you could choose anywhere in the world to go, where would you want to go?
Anywhere.
Dude. Okay.
In the world.
How long am I there?
However long you want to be.
Okay. You can't say that.
Okay. Like
24 hours.
No.
A full week vacation.
Like a vacation. Yeah.
Full week vacation.
Anywhere in the entire world, y'all know?
Yeah. I. I've been to a lot of places, but I'd like to go to like Japan. I think Japan would be really cool to go to.
Japan?
Yeah.
That's how they say it there.
Okay.
Just like
we're going to Kansas. I wouldn't know. I've been.
Huh? Why would you go to Japan?
I just think it's really cool. I think Tokyo's a really neat place. They got good food.
And they got a good song. Oh my god. Alright, where'd you go?
I don't know. I feel like more of like an island type of guy. You know?
Bring your pigs. Bring your pigs a tree.
So I'm an island boy.
Just trying to make it.
I don't know. What's a cool island
there? Like Cozumel.
No. Fiji. Literally.
Or the U.S. Virgin Islands. What? You got that challenge?
I didn't even think of it.
The Bahamas.
Cliff said, that's where I belong.
They call it the Klep Islands.
Yeah, I'll probably go to the Bahamas.
Ooh. Yeah. Interesting take.
Isn't that where they got the pigs?
They do have the
pigs. They do islands. Have the pigs, and they got some trees.
Yeah,
that's all Jake needs.
No. If I had to choose, I've always been like a big Venice, Italy type of guy, but... The only part about that is, like, it just being museums the whole time. Mm-hmm. See, like, while I'm young, I kind of want to go places where, like, I can do stuff on there. So I'm kind of thinking either going to, like, Switzerland.
I've been to Switzerland. Very nice.
I'm not going to Switzerland then. Go somewhere Klep hasn't been. I'm going to go somewhere, like, where have you been?
He's probably been everywhere.
I
think I'd go to Japan. No, if I had to choose. Russia... It's actually a pretty cool place to go.
Haven't been.
Yeah, that or England would be really cool and go to like the catacombs and stuff. Mm-hmm. That'd be cool. Yeah, that's probably where I'd go.
Nice. Mm-hmm.
So, yeah.
Okay. Now, you go to the doctor.
Mm-hmm.
He's like, guys, y'all got 24 hours to live. You hear that news. What are you going to spend your 24 hours doing?
Okay, 24 hours, I'm going to be awake the entire time.
Like, dead set, like, from, say, you go to the doctor's at 3 o'clock in the afternoon, he says you have 24 hours to live.
From there.
You're dying at exactly 3 o'clock in the afternoon.
They're going to put you down because you're going to turn into a zombie or something. They have to kill you.
Okay. I am...
leaving the appointment.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm
like, alright, I'll see you tomorrow then.
I might even stab him, because, I mean... I know exactly what I'm doing. So first of all, I'm gonna go see my family. I'm gonna grab all them, but okay guys, I'm sorry, but we're gonna have to get all the money and we're gonna go places. All of us is a family. So first of all, I'm probably gonna go skydiving really quick. So that'll take probably approximately like 2 hours to do
completely. Yeah.
So that'll be 2 of my hours, so I've got probably like 20 left.
Yeah, good. Okay. Spend a couple hours.
Yeah, so say I got 20 hours left, then I'll get in a plane, I'd probably go to Hawaii.
Why don't you just take the plane to Hawaii, then skydive off the plane?
Into Hawaii. Wow. That's a good one.
That is a good idea.
That was great.
Okay, so yeah. Probably go to Hawaii. Spend probably, honestly, 8 hours there hanging out with my family, doing all that stuff. So I'm down to about 16 hours. Mm-hmm. That wasn't good math. I'm down to about 12 hours.
Yeah.
12 hours.
So you still got half a day left.
Yeah, honestly, I'd probably just stay there. In Hawaii, just, with my family, just chill, do stuff.
Just finish your life there.
Yeah, it'd be a good place to die. Okay. I might jump in the volcano at like the last second, so I'd die on the way down. You know?
That'd be pretty cool.
Me?
Yeah.
Just.
Yeah.
Or you could skydive in the volcano the last second you want.
That would be so cool. Yeah,
skydive for
like
the...
I'd make the news. Yeah. I'd be famous. Mm.
That's pretty good, Jake.
Thanks. What would you do?
I think I want to go gambling, probably. You know.
That's kind of what I was going. Like,
yeah, I don't care.
Like if I start the timer in the middle of the day, I would go that night. I'd do my stuff first and then go at night.
Yeah, gambling. Just gonna say my goodbyes and then just.
Would you rob a bank first or something?
No.
Just
take whatever I had.
I wouldn't do that because. I would try to gamble and get my own money, so that way I could pass it on to my family.
And if I don't...
But if you rob a bank, the bank shouldn't take all that money back once you die.
Yeah.
You know?
True.
So if you just go gamble...
Plus, you'd have a chance of spending literally the rest of your life in prison.
Literally.
That's funny. All 3 hours.
They put you down to death before you die.
Yeah.
You're 24 hours because of 12.
Yeah, I'm probably going gambling, getting all my money. Try, you know.
You gotta say no goodbyes for my family.
I'll say yes.
No.
I just go to Oklahoma and try down the road. There's a bunch of.
Yeah, the Indian ones. Mm-hmm. Oh, because you're old enough too.
Just gonna go find my one slot machine and just. Like clicking can away the time. Status,
y'all can find me for the rest of my life. Hashtag YOLO.
Okay.
Yeah, no.
There's no way.
I'd like to live, like, are you aging like as you normally would?
No.
No, you can stay young.
That moment you chose to do it, that's
you can stay in your prime.
So I could be like 25 for the rest of my life. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Like forever.
You have to eat like an apple or drink some water or something.
Yeah, I'm still doing that.
Yeah, no way.
I'd rather just die of old age.
Exactly.
Okay.
Because, I mean, there's no
like
point.
Hundreds of years?
Yeah.
Like, what are you going
to
do?
Thousands of years? What are you going to do? Yeah.
Yeah, because, like, have you seen Eternals?
You're going to start multiple families?
Have you seen Eternals?
Huh.
So there's one of them on there. He starts his own, like, movie studio. And he'll make movies. And then he'll pretend he had a kid. And then he'll act like he was the kid. So then he'll start making movies that way. So he's like, that was my great-great-grandfather right there.
And my great-grandfather.
And it's really him.
And he just keeps going down.
It's like the episode 20 of the exact same series.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah. I'll tell you. Do you have any more questions after that one, or y'all? What do y'all think?
Like about that question?
Yeah,
no, I'm not living forever.
I'm just no. That's not fine.
Yeah, I agree. Yeah,
thank you. Down the energy drink.
Yeah, I'm absolutely combusting inside right now.
Speaking of energy drinks, what's y'all's favorite energy drink?
I have Rain Raspberry, not sponsored by Nostalgia Podcast.
I have no idea. I don't drink caffeine. I just had a few sips of that, and it was terrible.
Mine's Red Bull. I love Red Bull.
Yeah, you're a crazy guy. Red Bull's. That's next level.
No, I love Red Bull.
Is that really your favorite?
You know, I'm more of a Bang type of guy.
I don't like Bang. It gives me this, like, terrible taste in my mouth. Like, aftertaste, you know?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It's so bad. I can't deal with it.
Interesting. Are you a coffee guy?
No, I don't drink caffeine at all.
You a coffee guy?
No.
I love
that stuff. Upsets my stomach.
Can you get like a caramel frappuccino?
Like from Starbucks or something? Yeah, I can get something from Starbucks. But
it's good. It's like ice cream, basically.
Yeah. But like if I like go and make my own coffee at the house.
Yeah.
So bad.
We got some French vanilla over there if you want to try that sometime. Yeah,
I'll try it.
Sounds good.
What's your favorite drink of all time? Not just energy drink.
Oh my gosh, dude, one time
it can be anything.
Yeah
I was at a wedding. Mm-hmm. It's actually my brother's wedding. They have this ice cream. It was coffee in a big cup full of ice cream, so you'd scoop the ice cream. It was coffee flavored ice cream. When I tell you, that is the best thing I've ever had in my life.
A drink?
Yes, because you drank it and it was just ice cream in it, so it was melting. It was amazing.
Like a milkshake.
Yes. Oh my dude, y'all don't understand. If I had some right now, I got a gallon and it'd be all gone tonight.
That sounds terrible.
It was amazing.
Not the coffee ice cream, the part that it'd be gone.
Oh, it would. Yeah, like, dude.
Sounds terrible for you.
I'm craving right now.
What's your favorite drink of all time?
Shirley Temple.
He asks this every time we go somewhere to eat. He's like, can we get Shirley Temple? And some of them don't even know what that is.
Yeah,
I don't even know what that is.
So it's like
Sprite.
It's kind of like Sprite. You got grenadine. Which is like kind of cherry flavoring. Cherry.
Sprite cranberry?
No.
Has anybody ever looked at you like, we don't serve alcohol?
Yes, and it's literally, it doesn't have alcohol on it. Like, that's not how it's made.
Do you know what what's it called? You know what Arnold Palmer is?
Yeah, half lemonade, half tea.
No. Is it?
I think so.
Oh, it is, isn't it? Yeah. Yeah. Have you ever had an Arnold Palmer?
Mm-mm. It sounds good, though.
Yeah, it is good. Like, when you're a waiter, people say some really weird stuff, and you're like, please just tell me what it is.
It's like,
I don't know what this is.
We say lemonade and tea.
Lemonade, sweet tea, yeah.
Yeah.
Just ask half lemonade, half sweet tea.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Somebody needs all these lingos. I'm not with all that. Come on. I'm old.
That boomer talk.
I think my favorite drink is just sweet tea, dude. I love sweet tea. Mm-hmm. I could drink that all day, every day.
Yeah. What's yours? Oh, your,
Shirley Temple. Whatever the heck that is.
Delicious. You'll try it.
Delicioso.
If y'all could buy one thing, without cost being an issue, what would it be?
What's your chance? You can go first.
I think
I'm buying some big company. Like, it don't matter what it is, but I'm buying some big company.
See, I wasn't thinking that, but you said it, but I'm not going to do that because you said it. But I was kind of thinking I would buy, like, Goose Ferry Lake and, like, make everybody pay, like, an admission fee to get on it.
No, that would not work. No. People would not come here. And there'd still be those people that would, but not as many people would come here.
All right, fine. Just my idea. All right. Okay, fine. So I wouldn't do it then.
You probably would. I mean,
I'm going to buy the ocean then.
You would definitely make some money off of that, but you wouldn't make as much as you think. Because people would start being like, I ain't paying to go.
I'm buying the port in New Orleans and making them do a port fee.
Okay.
The small, like,
tariffs and stuff.
Yeah.
I'd just buy, like, a nice apartment building on, like, a beach.
Yeah.
Just rent it out.
Then just
chill.
Slowly grow the business.
I just need one.
Would you live in it? At the top of Pimp Suite?
I'd have a penthouse there, but I can have another house everywhere.
Do you allow kids there?
Do what?
Would you allow kids there? Like toddlers? Would you allow people to bring their kids?
Yeah.
Would they cause a problem?
What are you talking about?
would the toddlers cause a problem?
I don't know.
No way.
Would you be able to fight off all the toddlers at one time?
Oh. Okay.
How many toddlers?
Okay, so how old are these toddlers?
A toddler, like 3 years old.
3 years
two,
old?
Two, three, four.
A toddler.
Okay, I think it would be at least five, but like 2 and 3 year olds, they're hardly walking and they're really little.
I'm keeping it. Especially in your apartment building, I'm going.
Whenever my nephew was 3 years old, dude, he was running circles around the house, dude. Like, there's no stopping him.
Could he hold a knife?
I'm sure he can, but we never let him.
Do they have weapons?
That's what I'm saying.
Do the toddlers have weapons?
One of us is equipping them with weapons.
No guns, though.
Yeah, no. Only knives and spoons and stuff like that.
Spoons.
Like sport common silverware?
Yeah.
We're like a butter knife?
Yeah, butter knife.
Sporks.
Not sharpened or anything.
I think I'm holding off like 10, 15.
Oh, only?
What about like 50?
Well, no way. You're getting swarmed.
You definitely could, dude.
All at one time, just
coming in, yeah, just drop kick one of them. That's going to knock at least like three,
think
four
about
of
you
them
gotta,
down.
Okay, you got to think of it this way. So think about Call of Duty Zombies. You train them. You run, kick, run, turn around, kick. Like, you train
what
them.
What if they're like just trapping you, like all okay around you?
Did you know what I just said?
That's why you could like train them, like you could run mm-hmm through the door and then close the door behind you. And there's going to be some of them smack the door and
but
get knocked out. And you open up the door and they're going to keep coming and you just boom, boom. So, boom.
Basically, all you gotta do is defend him until you get to your car. Then you can the entire way,
like speed bumps.
You're
getting
a couple thousand at that point. Like, you're gonna get at least a nuclear.
I thought I was just like in a room by myself, and they just started coming. I'm just like fist fighting.
You gotta adapt, bro.
Come on, be creative.
Come on.
Okay, yeah, I wasn't thinking like
I'm
that.
Getting a nuclear. I'm getting a UAV. I'm getting everything.
Yeah. I'm getting the whole every single kill streak.
The VTOL.
Yeah.
VTOL worship. That would really kill a lot. So basically, you're playing zombies but with little kids.
Yeah,
that's
pretty much.
That's what we're doing. What round could you get to?
Yeah.
Depends, are we on town or are we... You good?
Yeah.
Jake, you're like the size of a toddler.
Shut up! Gosh!
How tall do you wish you were, though?
You couldn't even reach the ceiling.
How tall do you wish you were?
Oh, wow. That was your chair.
No, it wasn't. How tall do I wish I was? Why are y'all looking at me? Why do you expect me to wish that I was taller? Ask him. Stop being racist. Ask him.
That's not racist. What
stop being
about?
Tallest. How tall do you wish you were?
I'm a solid 6'2", 6'2 and a half right now. I wish I was like 6'4", 6'5".
I'd say 6'5".
6'6".
You have to grow like a foot and a half.
Yeah.
Oh my god, it's 6 inches. 6 inches is not that big. Think of a difference from 6 foot.
It's pretty big.
Yeah, 6 inches is pretty big.
Yeah, I mean, I would definitely... I'd be playing at the Hawks if I was 6'6", you know. Point guard skills. I'd be NBA. I'd be playing with Luka and all them.
Austin Reeves.
AR-15.
That's the Lakers. I was talking about the Mavs, but yeah, sure. Yeah, I'd be at the Lakers.
Oh my gosh.
Oh, that's so funny. Uh-oh. 6'6 would be a good height. 6'6. Yeah, what were you saying?
He just wanted to be taller than us. That's all he said. 6'6'4.
That's why people say that.
I think we're on to the next segment now.
What's the next segment?
Best of the best.
Best of the best. Bob.
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 Best of the best. Okay. What do we do best of the best of?
Like, the best of the year. So.
Best of the year.
First off, what's the best video game of the year?
Best video game of the year. What do you think? Does it have to be made this year, or we're just saying, like, this year, what was the most fun game to play? I think it should be that one. Most fun game to play this year.
Most fun we've had, yeah.
I already know what you're going to say. If you say, you're out the door.
Warzone.
Okay, I'm glad you. Good job.
Yeah, Warzone was pretty the best overall this year.
I was going to say Warzone, too. It'd be pretty fun.
You could buy both maps? Or?
I haven't played
this new map enough, so.
I thought you were going to say Modern Warfare, honestly.
Well, like,
the whole thing,
because, like, sometimes you want to go play the multiplayer, but sometimes you want to go Warzone. But, like, all together,
Call of Duty, Modern Warfare, because Warzone came from Modern Warfare.
Mm-hmm. I can't say that. I hate Modern Warfare. I might have to agree with you, just because that's, like, that's what I played the most this year. It's Warzone.
I also liked MLB The Show. Played that about 4 months straight. Pretty good.
Like, every day.
Yeah.
Like, Klep, are you going to go eat? No, I got to do my daily challenges real quick.
The early conversations?
Yes.
Oh, my gosh.
We were at the beach. And dude, literally, like, we wake up and we're like, you ready to go to the beach? Like, I can do my daily challenges real quick. I'm like, dude, we're at the freaking beach. Come on. Literally. Every day. I'd have to wake up early just to go in there and finish the challenges so we can come play with me. Go out, make sandcastles together.
All right, what about the song of the year? And I'd say song that was released this year, too.
Song released this year?
Yeah.
I don't know, like...
Kind of hard to think about all that stuff.
Yeah, I know, because, like, you don't really know. How about, like, what was your favorite artist this year?
Okay. That's harder for me to think of.
Really?
Yeah.
Just think of, like, who's your favorite song, and then just say, who's that?
Well, my favorite song was Rap Star by Polo G.
Polo G had a good year. He had a lot of features.
He did.
So is that what you're going to say?
Mine was going to be Polo G.
I don't think I can. I think I'm going to go with Kanye.
I'm going Polo G.
Oh, my. I love Kanye.
I love Kanye, but he didn't release any good
music. Yeah,
I know. Donda was so good.
No, it was not. It was trash. So was CLB. Trash.
Certified Lover Boy.
Yeah.
Who's your artist of the year, Jake?
24K Golden. Bro, he came out of nowhere this year. Absolutely love him. He's good. Good songs. You know, Prada. Yeah, Coco. Yeah, all the songs.
Mood.
Why are you always in a mood? It's a good one.
That was a pretty good one.
Thank you.
Yeah.
I switched him over to 24K Golden.
No, I'm on still Polo.
No. 24K Golden is...
I think that's the only song I heard from him was...
Mood. Yeah. Don't worry, when this is over, I'll play something.
Oh, okay. No.
We're about to listen to all nights.
I think that's it.
Really?
That
flew by.
Man.
That did fall by. So we make sure to like and subscribe.
Please.
Leave some comments down below on what we can do better again.
Yeah. Hey, we're going to shoot for 25 likes? 20 likes?
We'll do 25 this time. 25. I think right now we're at like 21. I'm
21 first. Yeah. 25 likes. And let's try to go up 5 subscribers, so 30.
Yeah.
But let's try to get 30 subscribers after this video.
Yeah.
So
not 30 subscribers from this video, like total on our channel, 30.
Yeah. So 5 more.
Yeah, mm-hmm. 5 more. 4. We're at 26.
Yeah. Dang, nice. Good job, guys. Good. Stop him.
26 after one video? That's pretty good.
Yeah. So we need 4 more, please.
Alright, yeah. So make sure y'all like, subscribe, comment, maybe even turn on the bell if you're feeling
like it. And go check out our TikTok.
Yeah, go check out the TikTok. We will put that in the description as well.
And the Cash Apps!
Yeah, Cash Apps will also be there.
They will always be there.
Always.
We didn't get any from the first episode. It's okay. It's okay. But
if you're going to give someone money, you'll agree. But see y'all in episode 3.
Alright. Peace.
Peace out, homeboy.